Hello, everybody, and welcome to this episode of Psychic Medium Toni G. This is such an amazing month and week and day for me. I'm totally excited because guess what I have in my hands? My newest baby. What if a transformational journey? I would like to say this is my favorite book that I've channeled so far. However, I just love all my books. So, and I can say that because I channeled them. I did not like literally write them. So this book though is, it's really special because it's an interactive book that will help you possibly change the way you look at your world and your life. Each page has a what if and then space to write. Now, the idea behind this book was every what if it were true for you, how would that make your life different? What difference would that, how would that change your life or make your life different? So I'm gonna open the book right now and I'm gonna look at a what if. And the first one, which I absolutely did hold on to because I wanted to read it to you guys. So it says, what if your life purpose is unconditional self-love? And from this love, all love in your life exists and grows. If you knew this to be true with every ounce of your being, what would you change? How would you live your life? What difference would that make if you knew your purpose was self-love? And from there, it just goes and grows and is beautiful and everything comes to you. If that were true for you, if you had that very basic, and it is true, what would that do for your life? Where would you be? I just want to read one more. Okay. What if unconditionally loving yourself brings you all you want and more? Okay, so obviously, there it is. I just opened it to a random page, and for some reason, these are the ones I chose today. This book is available on Amazon.com. It is so amazing. And I've said this before, I'm going to say it again. My 19-year-old niece and my sister, who is 10 years younger than me, I will not say her age, helped edit this book. They actually edited the whole thing. So they read the what ifs several times and corrected my, you know, PS22 grammar. And so they both said, this is a really good book, and they loved it. I mean, they edited my other books also, but they really liked this book. And so for every age, genre, or group, my niece was going through it going, oh, I really like this one. Oh, I really like that one. Oh, I really love this one. So it is a remarkable book at any age to open your mind, not to change your mind, because that's never, ever my goal, but to open your mind and help you have a bigger perspective of what could be, what might be. Who knows? I never knew about, I didn't grow up with the idea of reincarnation. And then one day I heard about reincarnation, and actually that's where this book originally sparks from. Once I heard about reincarnation and that we might come back to like heal the things we didn't heal, I instantly said, oh no, I am not coming back and doing some of these things again. I'm going to work on every relationship. I'm going to grow. I'm going to learn and understand every relationship I have. So if I do come back, or when I do come back, that those situations are completely different. And from that comes this beautiful baby that I love so much. Now, everybody that I know that has already acquired this book and has been going through it, they just tell me they love it, and it is transformational. So there's that. I'm going to try to prop this up right there so you can have a beautiful view of it. Now, I love this show because I get to integrate Blog Talk Radio along with Spreaker, iHeart, iTunes, Stitcher. Can you guys do me a really big favor and then send me a message in my email and let me know what happens. Siri, Google, and that other one. Hey Siri, hey Google, hey, I don't remember the other one. But say, hey Siri, can you play Messages from Above? Hey Siri, can you play Psychic Medium Toni G? And tell me what comes up, because I guess they're available there too. So I'm trying to think of all the places, SoundCloud, CastBox, it just a plethora of venues that this show is now available on. So more listeners, more love getting spread. And I see a blue orb over there, which is awesome. Yay. Okay, we're going to get started. I'm going to go to the first caller. When I call out your area code, please make sure you let us know where you are, where you're calling from and what your name is. And then also just have one question or one connection so that we can get to the next callers, because I love that my dashboard is always full of callers, new callers, and beautiful, wonderful people looking for answers and help. And I try to get to as many as possible. So let's go to the first one, 410. Whoopsie. Hold on. It's
Hi, it's Jackie. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Good. Congratulations on your book.
Oh, thank you. If you get it, please let me know what you think about it. Are you on a speakerphone right now, sweetie?
Yes.
Can you pull it to your ear?
Hold on.
Because we're using a system here, and I you're not coming through as clear as you could, and I want to make sure I hear every word you say. Okay, so what's your...
Okay.
Beautiful. What's your question or connection today?
Okay, here I am.
Yay!
Can you hear me?
I can.
So, I can barely hear you.
Okay, how can I help you today?
My question is, I haven't been feeling good the last couple of days. I was just wondering if you can get a grip on what's going on.
Okay, so the first thing I'm going to, rather than just get a grip on what's going on, I'm going to say she's ill. Yeah, we're going to start clearing this right away. Whatever it is, it can be cleared. It's starting to clear. I feel some stuff coming up through the throat and a little bit of nausea going on. We just had an eclipse, and I don't know a lot about astrology, but I know when these things happen, stuff comes out into the open, everything moves, and we need to purge. It's all about purging. So right now you're in the middle of purging and detoxing physically. Get a lot of water, I'm seeing cranberry juice and orange juice. And I'm also seeing a probiotic. A really good, strong probiotic would be very helpful during this time for you. Okay, sweetie?
Okay.
Excellent. I hope this was very, very helpful for you. Remember, when we detox, we're not only detoxing what's in the body, but we're detoxing what's in the mind. So if you've been working on something, as we detox emotional or psychological things or physical things, it can make us have flu-type symptoms. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, it does. It really does.
Excellent. You're so welcome. I hope you have an absolutely amazing rest of the week. And please call me back next week and let me know how you feel, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You're so welcome. Okay, I love this because who knew, right? This is so awesome. We're going to go to 480 next. Hello, 480. Where are you calling from? What's your name?
Good afternoon. This is Michael, and I'm in Las Vegas.
Hey, Michael. How have you been?
Good, good. There's been a change of plans of some sort. I actually applied for a job with a company that I used to work for in California, in Dallas, in medical sales, and just kind of waiting to hear back from them. I would have to start August 5th. so I would just pick up and go with the Bare Essentials and go to Dallas. Do you see that happening, or do you see me sticking around in Vegas a little
longer? No, I see that happening. I get a strong yes on that. As of right now, and the way everything is, I see you relocating. I see you having a strong, a very, very powerful new start. They're asking that when you... Okay, they're very funny. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. So when you go to Dallas, leave everything in Vegas. Don't take along any of your past. Like, it's a fresh new start. Yep. You have to be ready, ready, set, go, hit the ground running. There's not going to be an amp up time. You just have to, like, get there and hit it. You got to kill it from moment one. Yep. They're not going to coddle you or bring you along slowly. They expect you to come out of that gate straight away. If this was a horse race, they would expect you to take the lead and keep the lead. Just know they have great expectations for you, and you can fulfill this. It's not what they're asking of you. You are very capable of. You're going to be able to do this and then some. You just need to go there revitalized, regenerated, knowing you have what it takes. You've got this. Don't doubt yourself for a second. And don't think, and again, they're really, really, I cannot stress this enough. When you hit the ground, start running. Don't think you have a week or two. Acclimate and accelerate are your words for your new venture. If you do this, you will have great success, and you will have great finance and income, okay?
That's awesome. Yeah, because even, I just couldn't work for like an hour, like a salary position.
Yeah.
Even when I wait tables, again, it's because I'm getting tips, so I can work harder for, growing more. So yeah,
sitting
in with that mentality. And so I was really successful in California, but again, I was involved with fires. The mudslide kept me from work in Montecito, a year and a half ago. So it's just natural disaster after, and plus California taxes aren't the friendly.
Right, and California cost of living, seriously. That is,
exactly.
Oh my goodness. I feel like Dallas is a brand new start, and I feel like you're gonna, like, they're showing me you, and you have like this golden light around you. You're gonna really shine in California. You're gonna beam like you never had. I mean, in Dallas, I'm sorry. I mean Dallas. So when you get to Dallas, you're gonna shine. You have this golden light around you. Dallas is like a power place for you. Wherever you are in Texas, it's a power place for you. It's one of those places where you just shine. One of the places I shine is Florida. I should be there because just the weather is absolutely beautiful, but I'm not right now. But that's how it is for you in Texas. No matter where you end up in Texas, you are going to shine. You are going to reign. You're going to take control. You're going to have that power that keeps you going forward. Don't take that for granted and really take advantage of it. Okay, love?
Awesome. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. Have an amazing rest of the week.
You as well.
Thank you. Okay, I want to go straight to the next caller because, so people call in and sometimes it takes 5 or 6 months for them to get through to me. And if I can get through more people in one show, I absolutely want to do that because I know that it's your time and energy and I really appreciate that. So let's go to 415. Hello, 415. How are you today?
Hi, hello. I have tried many times. So, yes, that was me.
Awesome. Well, I'm happy that you got through today. How long have you been trying? About how long have you been trying to get through for?
I am kind of on the edge of creating a lot of new things.
Nice.
But my emotions kind of go up and down. Like, I'll be very excited, and then I feel kind of sad the next day. So it could be eclipse clearing things out, but anything you see about melancholiness that I've been waking up with.
Okay. One of the first things that I want to say is that you are transitioning right now. And as you go to sleep at night, it's really important. This is what they're telling me for you personally. As you go to sleep at night, you need to have a list of the positive things that you're on the verge of, and you need to see positive outcomes for them. If we go to sleep, that time when we're falling asleep is a time that can absolutely program us and program how our next days go. So it's really important for anybody, never go to sleep angry, never go to sleep upset, never go to sleep thinking about things that we're worried about, but rather switch those falling asleep thoughts to what's coming in, not only what's coming in, but having those positive visions and outcomes for them. Now, if you start going down what I call, if you get on crazy train and head to crazy town, which I do a lot, where our mind is just like going into that place where it's not those positive outcomes, it's those worries that we tend to have. Just stop yourself, take a breath, and then start thinking about the good things. Once you do that and you're on that track, you're going to wake up the next day so rejuvenated and so refreshed. Also, I get that you need a little bit more water and you need to have a little bit more nutrition, nutrients in your diet. So we can eat really healthy, but because of the way the soil is and because of a lot of things, sometimes we're not getting as many nutrients. So they're saying find something that is nutrient packed. I do a drink called, it's a green drink called Macro Life or Macro Greens by Macro Life. And I do it right away in the morning and boom. And everybody, I actually am like a dealer for this. Everybody that I've given it to, they are totally hooked on it. And they're like, oh my gosh, I can feel the difference in my health. Like, that's a strong statement. I can feel the difference in my health. Now, I don't distribute this product. I just happen to love it. So you might want to try that. But I feel like once you change your nighttime thoughts, everything else is going to fall into place for you. And you are transitioning. You're on a transformation right now. And as soon as, you know, they're just saying, like, I see this line in the sand, so to say, and it's a dark line. So I'm going to clear that line because as soon as you step over that line, everything, oh my goodness, everything is going to come flooding in faster almost than you think you can handle it, but you're going to be able to handle it.
Yeah.
So get your big girl pants on and let's go. Let's do this. You've got, like, here's my favorite statement lately. I've got one life that I know of that I'm living now. Past lives, future lives, we can't count those. And life is too short not to jump, not to take that step. So you've got however much time you have left. Life is too short not to jump in with both feet and do it. Just take it. If it doesn't work out, okay, you try it again in another way. But I feel like everything that you're working on right now, everything you're trying to accomplish, it's gonna come to fruition. You just need to go with it. You just need to say, I'm here, I'm doing it, what else have I got to do? And that's it, and go with it. Okay, sweetie?
Great, all right.
Excellent, thank you so much for calling in.
All right, thanks for the show.
Oh, you're so welcome. I'm gonna go directly to the next caller who is 610. Hello, 610. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Toni. This is Linda. That's my nickname. I'm from Pennsylvania.
Awesome. How can I help you today?
Would you please tell me an angel message for me?
Okay, I usually like to do a question to get into your energy, but if you just want a message, Linda, it's going to take a little bit longer, so give me... Okay, here we go. You need to... See, this is why I don't like giving straight-up messages. I like a question I can answer. But they're saying you need to get up, get out, and get going. Stop... Like you're spending too much time in your head and not enough time in the world. So you need to get up, get out, and start doing things. Does this message make sense for you?
I like to spend all my time at home. That makes sense.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you their exact quote was, get off the couch and out of the house. That was their exact quote, but I wanted to make it a little bit softer. Really, what I just said to the last caller and what I'm going to repeat to you is, it's time to live your life. Make a list of those things that you, I don't like to put it this way, but if you died today, what would you say? Oh, I could have done this. I should have done that. Make a list of those things and start doing them. Because of the people I talked to on the other side, one of the things that they realized is that they limited their life when their life was limitless. So your life is limitless. It's up to you to do the things you want to do the things you can do, to get up off the couch and get out. It's okay to do that once a week or twice a week, but you need to be in this world. You chose to come to this world. You chose to have these experiences. So do it. Get in it. Okay, sweetie?
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. Have an amazing week. We are going to go directly to the next caller, and the next caller is 678. Hello, 678. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, hello. My name is Casey, and I'm calling from Georgia.
Hey, Georgia. Thanks for checking in. How can I help you today?
Yes, I just wanted to know about a love relationship. I just, like, started talking to a guy, and I just kind of want to know what he feels about me.
Okay, so I'm sorry. I missed one part of that. You just started talking to a guy, did you say?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm just going to ask this question in a little bit of a different way because the angels are very literal. So I'm going to ask... is this a good guy for her? You know what? No. I'm sorry, sweetie. He's not a good guy. Unless you're a player slayer, this is not the guy you want to be talking to right now. He's not ready to settle down, and he won't be for a couple years. I don't care what he says to you. He is living large, and you can give your own definition to living large. But he is living large, and I know what that means from my angels. You should be able to put that together pretty quickly. And he is not ready for that. He talks a good game, and he plays a better one. But it's not genuine. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm going to tell you something. Now I'm going to tell you something better. I'm going to tell you something better. Because I don't like to tell somebody he's not the one and just drop it. You, my dear, have to start looking for men in different places. You go to a better place, you get a better man. That's all there is to it. So if you are spiritual, start taking meditation classes. Start taking yoga classes. Well, maybe yoga classes. Take spiritual retreats. Go to golf courses. and hit balls. I don't care. My friends say to me, I don't like golf. You don't have to play golf. The idea is to not be good at golf, because the person that likes you is going to come over and try to teach you to play golf or hit balls. That's all there is to it. I am going to tell you, mid-August, there is another guy coming in for you. This guy is much, much, so much better. He's more genuine, he has a better heart, and he is ready to settle down. So,
this is what I kind of wanted to throw out there at you. I had been in a relationship with this guy next month would have been a year.
Okay.
But, we had been talking about splitting up anyway, but had this other guy that, I went on a date with him Friday, and this time of I was just wanting to know, was you talking about the other guy, or were they seeing this guy, this one that just trying to come in now?
Okay, so so if you've been seeing somebody for about a year and you're dating somebody else, I'm going to say there's somebody brand new coming in August. I want you to start looking forward to seeing that person in August. And it's going to be right around mid-August. Get out about and meet somebody new. You meet a better man in a better place. Okay, that's all I can say. That's it. Thank you so much for calling in. I'm so happy that you did. And thank you for sharing your story with me. I want to thank everybody for listening in, for watching. This show is airing on WSCS. You can go to WSCS Sheboygan and watch it on video on demand. You just, in the search, you put T-O-N-I-G, Toni G. All my past shows will come up along with this very show. Don't forget, What If a Transformational Journey. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll be back with my next episode in about a month. Bye-bye for now.